Hello, this is your boy once again, Matt, and I've got some more stuff to talk about. I knew when I went out today on today's runs and errands and stuff that I had a feeling something else was going to come up in my mind to speak about. But I'm going to talk about coincidence, or really the lack thereof of any coincidence in this universe. I found that out quite a bit of time ago, that coincidences are never coincidences. They're intentional. They come from somewhere, and they're designed to get you somewhere, wherever there might be. Coincidences are used by the universe, I think, as a tool, and altered by spirits. I've seen them use that as well. Of course, spirits in the universe and us, we're all the same thing. We're all made out of the same thing. But semantics I use those particular semantics of language as to make understanding a little bit easier, more clear. But, well, coincidences can take a lot of different form, well, so-called coincidences. I had a couple happen recently. I'm going to touch on the first one about, if you have seen some of the other videos where I talk about the issues I've had with accepting my sexuality, accepting being gay, accepting the sexual fantasies I've dealt with, and being able to love myself for that. I talked about that in those videos, and the very day after I filmed those first videos, I was online, and one of my subscribers sent me a Facebook a friend request for the my Facebook page over there to, you know, add me on as a friend or whatnot. But so anyway, as soon as I logged in, I got an IM from a very old friend of mine. You know, I've known her since she was a little kid. She's known me that long. She knows my family. My family knows her. And she said, "I've been trying to get in touch with you." She had raised this kid that from his own mother was unable to take care of him, so she took one of the kids in and raised him herself. Now he's 20 years old, almost 21. But all he did was, what happened was, yeah, she was trying to get in touch with me because he was, he's gay, and he needed somebody as a mentor, so to speak, to help him understand his sexuality better, and just to be there for him, and someone to talk to. And she found me yesterday. It was funny, see that coincidence? The very day after I talk about, look, I need someone to talk to, I want to help people, I'm tired of not having anyone to talk to myself, then Christy, well, that's her name, she calls me, and she writes me, lets me know how to get in touch with this dude. So I do, and then he writes back and says, man, this couldn't have come at a better time. I really need someone to talk to right now. I don't really have anyone to talk to about some of this stuff. Something like that, he said. But see that, you know, the universe put him, me, and her, and all the other woman, my subscriber, at the right place at the right time to get me in contact with that dude. And the second one, that's a recent one that's occurred, is kind of on a different note, maybe a little more serious. But, well, this is what happened. I had written, I've spoken about Red before, a friend of mine that's a rapper and whatnot around Richmond, and been out hustling his music, hustling, you know, trying to get signed, trying to get promoted, you know, trying to be famous, see, and he just keeps going. But anyway, I'd written somebody I met online in Texas about Red, and said, look, you might want to get in touch with him. I think y'all might be able to help each other. So anyway, I go to Red's page, his new page, to find out, his MySpace page. I couldn't remember exactly what the screen name was. So I click on the screen name, go over there, and there's somebody else from Richmond that I've seen before on there with links to his songs, and he and Red were friends. But so anyway, I click over to the song, and it turned out it's a song and a memorial rap song regarding his best friend who died a couple of years ago. So I listened to the song, and it's a great song. But anyway, one of the comments on there was from the sister of the person, his friend who had died. So I felt something in intuition, like some tug, psychic tug, or something pushing me, saying, look, you need to write her. You know, you need to just drop her a line and let her know, you know, what you know. You know, let her know, see if you can ease her mind some and help, you know, just be a service. So I wrote her an email. And in the email, I was like, look, you know, your brother's, you know, your brother's more than fine. Perfectly fine. I know he's probably been watching over his friend. You know, when I think I said something to the effect of, you know, he'll be there for him when his boy finally crosses over from here, the person that died the other year will be there to meet him, you know. But anyway, I went out and ran some errands, and when I got home, I could feel the spirit of that guy, of the guy who had already crossed over, you know, around me. I had been talking to him. Well, and to make a long story short, 3 hours later, his friend was murdered. Immediately after I wrote a note to the sister of his best friend that he grew up with about, you know, that everyone's all right on the other side, that no one dies, you know, that people help each other cross over from the and help retrieve spirits sometimes from this dimension to the next. And 3 hours later, the guy was killed. So, and I got home and then I found that out, you know. And I was like, oh my fucking God. You know, I've seen tons of coincidences, but nothing like this. Absolutely nothing like this. You know, I just couldn't believe it, you know, that I wrote that and then he goes home to the other side a few hours later after I finish writing it. Anyway, she hasn't checked her messages yet. She hasn't logged in yet. I know that. But when she does, I don't know what she's going to think about it. But that relates to the situation that I talked about in the best Christmas present ever video that I did earlier today. Because I was kind of tripping over that situation. In a way, I didn't feel bad because I knew everything was all right, that both of them are much happier in the spirit world than here. But I felt terrible for the family and his friends and all of those people, you know. And I just kind of felt sick in my heart. I was like, I knew it happened for a reason and what I wrote, but it still, it hurt me. It hurt me real bad, you know. And I don't usually feel hurt like that, but I've seen this dude around a lot, and in this world, some of my friends knew him, I didn't know him, but like that, but I've seen him around my neighborhood chilling and stuff, so that shit fucked me up and hurt me real bad, and you know, the rest of the story is in the best Christmas present ever video that's on here too, but anyway,